guys! So I've got another really exciting new planner to show you. I found this about a week ago when I was trawling Amazon looking for new planners, as I often do, and I was fascinated to come across this intriguing mystery planner. There was no information about what brand it was or where it was from, but the pictures looked really amazing and it was quite cheap, so I ordered one. I showed the pictures to my friend PlannerGirl777 and she observed that it looked like the classic layout of Korean planners. If you think of the Molong diary, it's the same layout. I'll show you in a minute in comparison with that. And when it arrived, I discovered that it was indeed a Korean brand. Since then, I found another shop that sells them and gives some more information about them. It's a brand called Ardium. It's the Kawaii Pen Shop that sells them. I'll link that website down below. And they seem to make a range of different planners, which all have this sort of cute, flowery type style. So this planner comes in a few different designs. This one I think is called Tropical Blue. There's also one with more black. It's black and orange, if I remember, and a couple of other ones, and they're all floral and really nice designs. In terms of size, it comes in two sizes, an A6 and this one, which seems like pretty close to a B6 to me. This is a B6 notebook from Stalogy, and you can see that it's just a little bit bigger, but the actual paper is the same size. In comparison to an A6, it's that much bigger. And then in comparison to A5, it's right in the middle, so it's just a perfect B6. So I think that this would fit quite well in one of these Doki Books Disc Agenda Serene covers, if you wanted to do that, because it doesn't come with a pen loop. So you can see there, it's a little bit tight, but it fits pretty well. Because this is a personal size cover, but it actually fits B6 size bound planners. So the cover is kind of halfway between hardback and softback. It's like some of the Hobonichi Weeks covers that are bendy and flexible, but not like a typical softback Moleskine or Leuchtturm, if you think of one of those. It feels like cloth. So unlike, say, the Molang diary, this doesn't have a plastic removable cover, it's just bound. So I think the Hobonichi Weeks is the closest comparison. It's quite smooth and silky. And as you can see, it's bendy, but pretty sturdy. So a very nice feeling cover. On the front, it says AY, which confused me because that's not actually the brand. The brand is Ardium, and there's nothing on the back. And that's what the side looks like. So when you open it, it gives you a little bit of information. That was how I found out that this was Korean. So ardium.co.kr. And if you want to, I'll just hold this here for a second and you can pause it and hopefully read that. It just tells you a bit about the company. It's a stationery brand. And it says Ardium Flowery Journal, subject and name. And then it says, your year will be filled with the happiness with Ardium Flowery Journal. And it's got this nice cherry blossom pattern here. So this planner has a very, very strong floral theme throughout. I'm not always the biggest fan of florals, but I just really like this one. It's very colorful and beautiful. So then it says Ardium Flowery Journal. And here you get a year on two page horizontal layout, which is quite interesting because I haven't seen this type of layout very often, and it's got this nice floral band at the top. So the thing I like about this planner is that it's already very much pre-decorated. So if you don't want to decorate, it's almost like it's got washi at the top, and you'll see as we go through it, really colorful right the way through. And it has a single bookmark in yellow. So it has January through June on this side, and then July through December on this side, and it says yearly plan at the top. This is undated, which usually is a deal breaker for me. I bought this because I was so curious about it, and it was an interesting layout, which I haven't seen very often. And I think for something like a gratitude journal or a more niche planner, not an everyday planner that I depend on for dates and forward planning, it would be okay. But I think probably James is going to use this when his Molang diary runs out, because he really likes this type of layout. Then the next spread is a vertical year on two pages. And I love these spreads. I really think that they're useful either for tracking things like bank balances or habit tracking, or for an overview of your year. So you get 1 month per column, starting with January, and then it gives you all of the months, all of the days of the month. But because this is undated, unlike, say, the Hobonichi or the Jibuntecho or the Leuchtturm versions of this, it doesn't actually tell you what day, say, the 1st of January, the 1st of February is. Then you get another floral page here. This is just a floral notes page. And then, or not notes, just a like a kind of fronts piece. And then it goes on to monthly plan. I really like the font in this, by the way. I'll bring it up closer just so that you can see it. It's a very pretty font. Sans serif. And then you get your first monthly spread. So unlike the Molang, which I've got here, this is James's current planner. The Molang diary gives you a year at a glance at the beginning. 2016, 2017 is this one. This one doesn't, which I actually think makes more sense, because if it's an undated planner, then I feel like it should be undated all the way through. I guess the logic of giving you the yearly spread is so that you can use it for reference when you're writing in the dates. But I kind of think that makes it a little bit slightly dated in a way, in that, like, say you're a ridiculous planner addict like myself and you buy this planner and then you don't use it for 3 years. If it has a dated yearly spread at the beginning, then that would be wasted. Whereas if it's totally undated, then you really don't have any pressure. You can leave it as long as you like or come back to it and, you know, use a couple of weeks and then come back to it a year later and it doesn't matter. So it's a Sunday start, which I find annoying, but I know that there are a lot of people, particularly in North America, who are used to this style. So then you get a line here to write in the date. So Sunday through Saturday, and Sunday is written in red. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. So if it's a month that, say, starts on a Saturday and has 31 days, then you'll end up having to divide these in half, which is the same as the Molang diary, and most planners seem to be like that. And then here it gives you a space where you can circle which month it is and write the name of the month at the top, I guess, because there's a little blank space there. And then it's got some space for notes here that's lined, and it says monthly plan. And then it starts into the week. So this is exactly the same format as the Molang diary, if you're familiar with that. It's got the weeks interspersed with the months. I would personally actually prefer it to have all the months at the beginning so that you can date your months and then go on and date your weeks, because my experience with the Molang diary, which I dated for James, is that you can end up with some blank space because it gives you 5 weeks per month. And you kind of can end up with a blank spread, or you're not sure if you should date that week for the current month or the next month. So I would kind of like it if it just had all the months at the beginning and then all of the weeks, so that you can just go on week after week after week, the way the Hobonichi does it. But that seems to be the style, because this and the Molang both do it like this, where they've got the months mixed in with the weeks. And I know that some people prefer it like that. So it says to-do list this week, and then it has the numbers 1 through 12, so again, you can circle which month it is, and then it's got this list of 7 check boxes, so it's got 1 checkbox per day, and then you've got your 7 daily boxes, and I really, really like this layout. This is the main thing that attracted me to this planner, is this vertical layout. I think that this is a really underused layout. I don't know why it's not more popular, although, as I mentioned, it seems to be a standard for Korean planners, but for some reason elsewhere you don't see it very often. And I think it's really nice how it allows you to have a vertical layout in a smaller planner. So, you know, if you have the vertical columns like this, then it's hard to make it work in a personal planner. But for this type of layout, it works really well. And my favorite thing ever, it means you've got equal space for every day, no shared weekends. So this is also a Sunday start, which is kind of interesting. So the months and the weeks both have a Sunday start, and Sunday is in red, and then there's a little line up above where you could write the date. If I was using this myself, I think the fact that it's undated means that I would just use it for something, like I said, like gratitude or meal planning or something where I don't actually have to write the dates in, because it doesn't matter, because I just hate writing dates in. But that's just me. And then you get the same thing 5 times. I think, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, and then you get the next month, which has a different floral decorative banner at the top. Layout is the same, and then you get the same color here at the top of this little box. So every month is different. Every month has a different floral design. So I'll just show you the third month. And obviously, because it's undated, you could start this any time of the year. So the next one looks like this. And the to-do list here is in green. These are in alternating colors. So in this one, the to-do list little banner is brown. This one is green. This one is a different shade of green. Then you get your weeklies. Then you get the next one, which looks like this. The next one after looks like this. So I think that these florals are really, really beautiful patterns. And this is what drew me to the planner. Next one looks like this. That and obviously this layout, which I really like. Then this one. So you get a whole range of different colors and different patterns. This one looks like the cover of the planner. Some of them are brighter than others, but altogether I just think that they're stunning. Really, really nice patterns. This one. And I think the fact that they carry on through the monthly spread and also the weekly spread just gives it this nice touch of color every week. So you really don't have to do any decorating, but it will look beautiful and colorful right from the start. Here's another one. And then that's the end. And then you have another floral pattern page. And then it says free note. And then you get some notes pages with a little floral motif at the bottom, line notes pages. So the color of the lines changes on every spread. So this one is blue, this one is red, this one is green, this one is brown, etc. So it uses all of the colors that you saw throughout the planner, those little to-do note boxes. These are the same colors that it uses for the lines here. And in terms of paper quality, the paper feels reasonably thick. My impression of it just from feeling it was that it wasn't like fantastic paper quality, although it is definitely thick. You can hear how it sounds here. It feels kind of smoother than Happy Planner paper, but I'd say probably more similar to Happy Planner paper than any other kind of thicker paper like Lime Life or something that I can think of. It feels on the matte side, but it doesn't really have a tooth. It's very smooth. Anyway, but then I did a pen test, and my pens are all on the fine side because I'm left-handed and they smudge otherwise, and I just like fine nib pens anyway. So these are all fountain pens, the Pilot Decima Extra Fine, the Pilot Metropolitan Fine, the Caveco Sport Extra Fine, which is actually quite a bit thicker than the Pilot Metropolitan Fine, the Caveco Student Extra Fine, and the Parker 51, which I think is a medium. I don't know because I bought it used and it doesn't say what the nib size is, but I'm assuming that it's medium because it's a lot thicker than any of the others. And I was pleasantly surprised that it held up quite well. You can see the Parker 51. There isn't actually any proper bleed through, but it's kind of threatening. It's like on the verge of bleed through. With the others, there is a bit of ghosting, but it's really not bad at all. So then the end looks like this. It's got a place for personal information and in case of emergency, and it has this nice floral pattern here. And that's it. So I'd say this is a really, really nice planner if you like color. And you can see as well on the side, it looks really beautiful. If you look the side and the top, I really like this effect. If you like color, you don't really feel like you want to decorate, but you'd like it to already look pretty, it's great for that. It has this really cool layout. I think the combination of the florals and the layout just make this an awesome planner and really special. It stands out because you don't see anything else like this. The closest that I know of, like I said, is the Molang. But this has a very different feel because the Molang has the little cartoon character illustrations, whereas this has this much more artistic, kind of elegant feel to it. So that is the Ardium Flowery Planner. Let me know if you have any questions about it. Like I said, I'll link the shop, the Amazon link, and also the Kawaii Pen Shop where you can get this down below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye!